Hello all. So today we will learn about the drugs for HIV virus. Okay, that is human immunodeficiency virus. Now remember, the treatment or the drugs for HIV virus is known as heart therapy. Okay, heart stands for highly effective anti-retroviral therapy. Okay, highly effective antiretroviral therapy, or sometimes it is only known as ART. ART stands for antiretroviral therapy. Okay, so both terms are used. Now let's see what are the drugs we have for HIV. So for that we must know the structure of HIV virus. Okay, so if we talk about the structure of HIV virus, it contains an envelope. Okay, it contains an envelope. And on this envelope, it has various proteins known as GP. GP stands for glycoprotein. GP stands for glycoprotein. So it has various proteins like GP120, GP41, etc. on this envelope. Okay. Now this virus, it contains an inner capsid. It contains capsid. Okay. This capsid is made up of protein, envelope is made up of lipids. Now it contains a genetic material. The genetic material in HIV virus is a single-stranded RNA. Okay, single-stranded RNA. And it contains three genes. The one gene which is present on this RNA is gag gene. Okay, and it contains three enzymes. It contains three enzymes also. The enzymes on HIV virus are three. You can write RIP, rest in peace. The first enzyme is reverse transcriptase. We will see what will be the function of this enzyme. Then you will write integrase. And finally, protease. Okay, finally protease. So it has outer glycoprotein, capsid, single-stranded RNA containing various genes and enzymes. Three enzymes, RIP, rest in peace. Now let's see how HIV virus affects a human cell. So how it affects a human cell? It affects those cells of human which contain a receptor known as CD4 receptor. Okay, CD4 is the main receptor to which these glycoproteins they bind. These glycoproteins, they bind to CD4 receptor, and it takes help of certain other co-receptor. It takes help of certain other co-receptors. Now there are two co-receptors in cases in which it will bind. The first co-receptor you will write is CCR5, and second you will write is CXCR4. These are the two co-receptor with the help of which HIV virus binds, and after that it will enter into the human cell. Okay, so before entering into the human cell, let's see, we have certain new drugs for HIV. Okay, so let's write for certain new drugs for HIV. Okay, now these new drugs, remember, they are not first line drug, they are second line drug. They are second line drugs, and they are only given as a salvage therapy. They are only given as a salvage therapy. Salvage therapy means in resistant cases of first line drug, we give them. Okay. So let's talk about these new drugs. The first drug is GP, that is glycoprotein 41 inhibitor. Okay. Glycoprotein 41 inhibitor. The drug name is Enfuvirtide. Now how to remember this drug? Remember, it is having EN word. EN means envelope. So GP is present on envelope of a virus. Fu means it will inhibit the fusion of this virus with human cell. That is why it is known as fusion inhibitor. It is known as fusion inhibitor. Okay, and vir means it is inhibiting some virus. So envelope, fusion virus inhibitor. Now let's write certain properties of enfuvirtide. Enfuvirtide is given by a subcutaneous injection and it is only effective against HIV 1 virus, not against HIV 2 virus. Okay, and remember HIV has two strains, HIV 1 and 2. It is only effective against HIV 1. And what is the side effect? The main side effect is injection site reaction. When we give the injection, there are reactions, redness, pain, etc. Okay, now let's talk about, so this was the first drug, GP41 inhibitor, enfuvirtide, also known as fusion inhibitor. Now let's talk about second drug. The second drug we have is CCR5 inhibitor. CCR5 inhibitor, the drug name is Maraviroc. And can we say that this Maraviroc will block this receptor so that the virus will not able to enter into the human cell? That is why Maraviroc is known as entry inhibitor. Is known as entry inhibitor. Okay, now let's talk about certain properties of Maraviroc. Remember, Maraviroc is given orally and it is effective against both HIV-1 as well as HIV-2. Okay, HIV-2. So it's an approved drug, Maraviroc. Now there are certain drugs like Maraviroc which are right now not approved, but they are under clinical trials. These drugs are Vicriviroc, and you will write Seni, you'll write Senicriviroc. So these drugs are under trial, but Maraviroc is an approved drug. Now recently a third drug came, a new drug, that is a CD4 blocker. The drug that blocks CD4 receptor on human cell, the drug name is Ibalizumab. The name of the drug is Ibalizumab. Okay, so it's a new drug recently approved. Okay, now you write just other drugs which are under clinical trial. You'll write GAG inhibitors. The drugs are, you'll write Bevirimat. The drugs are Bevirimat, and the other drug is, you will write, the other drug you will write is Vivecon. Now remember, these drugs are known as maturation inhibitors. Maturation inhibitors, but the point is these drugs are not approved. They are also under clinical trials. They are right now not approved. Okay. So MAT word is coming, maturation inhibitor. Okay, so these are the new drugs in cases of HIV virus. Now let's talk about first line drugs in HIV virus. Okay, so these are the second line drugs only given as an add-on drug. So let's talk about now first line drugs in HIV virus. Okay, now let's see first line drug. Suppose, sir, this is a human cell. This is a human cell. And let's suppose that the HIV virus now has entered into the human cell. Okay, now when it enters into the human cell, remember it contains single-stranded RNA. Okay, this single-stranded RNA of HIV virus gets converted into double-stranded DNA. It contains into double-stranded DNA. Now, you know, to convert DNA into RNA, that process is known as transcription. To convert RNA into DNA, this is known as reverse transcription. So here the enzyme which is required is reverse transcriptase enzyme. So what is the function of reverse transcriptase enzyme? Reverse transcriptase enzyme converts single-stranded RNA into double-stranded DNA. Okay, now this DNA, remember, it gets attached to human DNA. Suppose this is a human DNA. Okay. This strand of DNA gets transferred. This strand of DNA gets transferred and get integrated with human DNA. It attaches to human DNA. To attach this into a human DNA, the enzyme required is integrase. As the name implies, integrase. So integrase causes transfer of this DNA into human DNA, it integrates it. Now after this, this human HIV virus, it forms its proteins. Through translation of DNA, it forms viral proteins. Now for assembly of this viral protein so that complete HIV virus is formed, for assembly of viral protein, the enzyme, the third enzyme which virus will require is protease. So the enzyme which is required for assembly of viral protein is known as protease. So these are the three enzymes which are required by the virus. The first is reverse transcriptase enzyme, integrase enzyme, and protease. Protease is required for assembly of viral protein. So we have three first line drug which will inhibit these three steps. The first one we'll be having is reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Second we have is integrase inhibitors, and third we have is protease inhibitor. Okay, so in first line drug we have three drugs. You'll write the first one we have is reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Okay, let's write the short form as RTI. Second, you'll write integrase inhibitor. And the lastly we have is protease inhibitor. So these are the three drugs we have. So we know their mechanism of action. Reverse transcriptase inhibitor will inhibit conversion of RNA into DNA. Integrase inhibitor will inhibit the attachment of viral DNA to host DNA. And protease inhibitor will inhibit assembly of viral proteins. Okay, so let's start with the first drug, that is reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Okay, reverse transcriptase inhibitors. Okay, so these drugs, they will inhibit the conversion of RNA into DNA. Okay, they will inhibit the conversion of RNA into DNA. These reverse transcriptase inhibitor, you will write, all these drugs are oral drugs and they are divided into three. They are divided into three. You will write the first one is nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, short form, which is also known as NRTI. Then you will write nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor. The short form is known as NTRTI. Okay, and finally we have is non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, which is also known as NNRTI. Okay, now let's understand what does it mean. Okay, so NRTI, nucleoside, nucleotide, and non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase. Now the point is, what happens with nucleoside? Remember, these nucleoside, they get converted into nucleotide. To convert a nucleoside into nucleotide, they require phosphorylation. Inside the cell, they undergo phosphorylation. Would nucleotide require a phosphorylation? No phosphorylation is required. No phosphorylation is required. Now, as they are converted into nucleotide, they are now fake nucleotides. This reverse transcriptase enzyme will not able to distinguish between a normal nucleotide and these drugs which are fake nucleotide. Because of this reason, they are competitive inhibitor. They competitively inhibit reverse transcriptase enzyme. Nucleotide is also a competitive inhibitor of reverse transcriptase enzyme. What about non-nucleoside? Non-nucleoside, remember, is a non-competitive inhibitor. They are not fake nucleotides or fake nucleotides. Okay, they are non-competitive inhibitor, which are also known as allosteric inhibitor. They bind to some different site. Okay, allosteric inhibitors. Okay, so try to remember. So this is how we can distinguish them. So one will require phosphorylation and competitive inhibitor, no phosphorylation, competitive inhibitor, no phosphorylation, non-competitive inhibitors. Okay, now you'll write one point that this NRTI and NNRTI, NNRTI and these two drugs, they are effective against both HIV-1 as well as HIV-2. Okay, but what about NNRTI? NNRTI, remember, they are only effective against HIV-1 virus. They are not effective against HIV-2 virus. Okay, so which anti-HIV drugs are not effective against HIV-2 virus? There are two classes of drug. The first is NNRTI and second is enfuvirtide. These two drugs, they are not effective against HIV-2 virus. Okay, HIV-2 virus. So let's write their names first. Then we will discuss individually. So let's write the names of the drugs. Okay. So first you will write as NRTI, that is nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, NTRTI, and lastly NNRTI, non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. So here you will write a mnemonic. The mnemonic is DASLS. DASLS. D stand for didanosine. Abacavir, zidovudine, zelsitamine, emtricitabine, lamivudine, and finally cevudine. So these are the examples of nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. So you can write a mnemonic DASLS. What about NTRTI? In NTRTI, we have only one drug starting from the word T, that is tenofovir. The only drug we have among nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor is tenofovir. Now what about NNRTI? Remember, these drugs, they will have vir word in between. Okay. So you can write a mnemonic NEED. Relief. Need relief. N stand for nevirapine. The vir word is coming in between. Efavirenz. Ictravirine. Delavirine. And finally, relpinvirine. So you can make a mnemonic. Need relief. Okay, need relief. There is a new drug which recently has been approved, that is dolavirine, but it is not available in India and it is recently approved in America, USA. Okay, dolavirine. Now let's start with individual drugs. So let's start with the first one, that is NRTI. Okay, let's talk about NRTI. Okay. So let's talk about these drugs, NRTI first. Now these NRTIs, these drugs are given orally and we know they are effective against both HIV-1 and HIV-2. HIV-1 as well as HIV-2. Now this NRTI, first point we will write, they have certain common toxicity. Their side effects are very common. There is a basis why they have certain common toxicity, because we know that they, in virus, they inhibit reverse transcriptase enzyme. Remember, they also inhibit one enzyme present in mitochondria of humans. They inhibit mitochondrial DNA polymerase. it is also of various type, you will write gamma type. Okay, this mitochondrial DNA polymerase gamma, it is just like a reverse transcriptase enzyme of HIV. So it also inhibits this enzyme. Because of inhibition of this enzyme, the energy production generally decreases and the cell division, its cell division hampers. Because there is no energy, the cell will not divide. Because of this reason, DNA polymerase is required for DNA synthesis, so the cell division will be hampered. Because of this reason, they have certain common toxicity. You know any rapidly dividing cell in our body? So you will write they cause bone marrow suppression. So their common toxicity is bone marrow suppression. Okay. In bone marrow suppression, remember, more commonly which is seen is anemia and neutropenia. This is most commonly seen. Thrombocytopenia is very rare. Okay. Because generally platelet, they don't have nucleus or mitochondria. That is why thrombocytopenia is rare. Okay. Second, you will write myopathy. This is their common side effect. Third, you will write peripheral neuropathy. Okay. Then you will write pancreatitis, common side effect. And lastly, you will write insomnia and vivid dreams. Okay, so these are the common side effects of NRTI, nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor. Now you will write bone marrow suppression. It is maximum seen with a drug known as zidovudine. It is maximum seen with the drug zidovudine. Even myopathy is maximum seen with zidovudine. Okay, peripheral neuropathy, you will write it is maximum seen with a drug known as stavudine. Stavudine, and you will write it is not seen with a drug known as lamivudine. It is not seen with a drug known as lamivudine. Pancreatitis, you will write it is seen maximum with didanosine. Maximum pancreatitis is seen with zidovudine, didanosine. So you have to remember, maximum bone marrow suppression or anemia is seen by zidovudine. Myopathy also. Peripheral neuropathy is by stavudine. Pancreatitis is by didanosine. Peripheral neuropathy is not seen with lamivudine. Okay. So these are the common toxicity of NRTIs. Okay. Now let's discuss about individual drugs. Okay. Let's discuss about individual drugs. So let's make a